Hello and welcome everyone, it's Martin here at CryptoGains. Of course, first of all, we need to contextualize what just happened yesterday. There was a massive correction, Bitcoin and other major cryptocurrencies dropping more than 30%, and probably a lot of new market participants have been shocked and unable to explain what's going on. Of course, it's unrealistic and not reasonable at all to try and think in a reductionist terms and attribute yesterday's events to a single cause. But some of the likely reasons were, of course, Elon Musk, who tweeted over the last couple of days that he's withdrawing some of his support for cryptocurrencies and Bitcoin in particular. In addition to that, Chinese are cracking down on cryptocurrency use, which, of course, the biggest market reducing crypto consumption is a big hit on the market. But probably most importantly, it was the fact that the market was over-leveraged with a lot of open positions which were quickly liquidated, driving lower and lower prices continually. However, Bitcoin was able to reclaim 40,000, although it's currently consolidating. But basically, analysts from Bein Crypto believe that if it reclaims 40,000, 43 may be a next reasonable target. However, 30,000 remains one of the most robust support areas. Bitcoin dominance has jumped somewhat to 44% simply because the downfall in altcoins was more significant. But as we can see from this heat map, pretty much all of the crypto world is in red with the exception of Bitcoin. At the same time, the global cryptocurrency Google searches reached a new all-time high beyond the crypto hype of the end of 2017, beginning of 2018. So lots of mixed messages at the moment. So let's take a look at the charts and see how we can trade some of these insights. To me, above 39,500 would be a good level to aim for before initiating long positions in Bitcoin with targets 40,750 and 42,500. Conversely, below 39,500, the downside prevails with the nearest support at 37,600 and then 35,200. But of course, as I already said, the longer term support is at 30,000, which is around the lows that we saw yesterday. And now let's take a look at Ethereum. For Ethereum, to me, 2,575 is a reasonable support area. Above that level, buying Ethereum with targets 2,770 and 2,900. Conversely, if we break below 2,575, more downside is possible with the nearest target for the short positions at 2,415 and 2,200. Next, we're moving to Litecoin. For Litecoin, I'd like us to break above 205 before initiating long positions with targets 210 and 220. Conversely, below 205, downside is more than likely to prevail with the nearest targets at 200 and 190. And now we're moving to Bitcoin Cash. For Bitcoin Cash, I like the level of 760 as a pivot point to initiate long positions with target at 800 and 850 afterwards. Conversely below 760, we could see more declines to 740 and 710. And finally, let's take a look at Dogecoin. For Dogecoin, we have robust support around 0.35. So above that level, buying Dogecoin with target 0.38 and 0.42. Conversely, the downside will prevail below 0.35 with target 0.33 and 0.3. These are all ideas for today. Thanks for joining me. Trade wisely and keep learning with the video education section. And very importantly, remember to join the CryptoSignals Made Easy channel for lots of insightful articles and trading ideas. Thanks for joining me today. Trade wisely and I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.